Okay guys, this is Cruz Roy, and I just want to talk about something I got, and I did a lot of internet searches, and I put together the way I would think, after doing a lot of research, the best thing to have on that combination of drones. What I wanted to show you first was a comparison between the Phantom 1 and the Phantom 4. Now the Phantom 1 was one of the first Phantoms to come out. Had red stripes to tell you where the front was in orientation. It also had the lighting underneath, the LED lighting. It had to carry any type of LiPo battery, like this one's modded to take a 5200, which is the Phantom 4 is like a 5300, so pretty close in runtime and everything with this guy. No camera on board. You'd have to add a basic gimbal and a GoPro. Now this is a Phantom 1, and it had your compass and your antennas all hanging out. The skids usually just hot glued in, and it did very well, and it used the NASA software. I'm not sure about the Phantom 4. I don't think it uses NASA anymore. It's still their product. I don't know what they name it. I know you hear terms like Lightbridge and all that. But the Phantom 4, I think, works a little different than the Phantom 1 now. Phantom 1 was pretty basic. Without the battery, it's like a feather. It weighs nothing. It had an LED light on the back that told you things like low battery, out of range, return to home, all that functions. And it just blinked. And as for this Phantom 1, all the nuts holding the props were righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. So the problem is, we all know the props spin in different directions. So the problem with this one was, if you weren't tight, you'd lose props. So, I mean, they started somewhere. They had their failures, but this drone here I like toying around with. And it's still a really good little drone. I got the PIDs set up really fast, so this thing moves with the 5200 in it. It has no problem flying around, and I can swap out props, I can swap out batteries. I can do pretty much anything I want with this one. But that's the Phantom 1. Now, the Phantom 4 comes with pretty much everything. I mean, you got obstacle avoidance, a really big battery, but it's proprietary now. You can't swap it out. I haven't seen any clones yet, but that's not saying they're not popping around out there. So you have to use their batteries, but you get a good long run time. Your fingers get tired flying the Phantom 4. You got a really nice camera, changeable lenses, obstacle avoidance, resonant sonar, quick release props. I mean, what more can you ask for? And it's very, very smooth and shiny, and they finally got rid of all the wires like the Phantom 1. They're all in here, but they're hiding. So, I mean, DJI has gone from the Phantom 1 to the Phantom 4, and now they have the Phantom 4 Pro and, of course, the Mavic. But I just wanted you guys to take a peek at these. If you never saw them side by side, typically this is the front of the Phantom 4. The front of the Phantom 1 had the battery compartment and your stripes. Like I said, the Phantom 4 comes with the camera. A lot of people complain and they say the X-Star, oh, get the X-Star, it's better. You can remove the camera. You know what? I like the integrated camera. I've had the isolator types on the Phantom 3s and 2s, and the cameras will fall off during a very severe landing, or even worse. This on a severe landing, the most you'll do is bend the R-arm, which this had when I purchased it, and for $12, I bought one from China. I waited about 3 years to get it on this little tiny boat, and I did the work myself, and the thing works absolutely flawless right now. They are tough to get into, this one. You can see all the screws. Once you remove the screws, it comes apart fairly easy. You can do what you want. This one, the screws are hidden and they're not. It's kind of like opening an iPad or an iPhone. So again, let me just flip them. get an idea of what they look like. Same situation. I gotta tell you, the Phantom 4 is probably 3 times the weight of the Phantom 1. But you got a bigger prop set up, 9-inch, these are 8-inch, bigger motors. So, these motors, I gotta say something, this drone is very old. You know, probably when they first came out, I forgot what year, never changed the motor. And I've pushed this thing, like I said, it's modded with 5200 milliamp batteries, and I push it as hard as I can. Now, on the new technologies with the Phantom 4s, you push them too hard, you'll get an ESC or motor too hot error. But if you let off, it'll cool down and go back. But these are really super fast. You're talking 45 miles an hour. I never clocked this one, but I guarantee you it's going almost as fast as the Phantom 4. Not as fast, probably 30 miles an hour, but it's pretty fast for a Phantom. And just tip it one more time. And I just wanted to show you that. You know, they went from a red symbol, now they got this nice smooth body with a silver shiny. I've seen one that's gold plated, which actually looked pretty cool. Not that I'd buy it, but anyways, the whole idea of this video is, like I said, I did a lot of soul searching on another drone. Let me put the one over here. And just a lot of people, a lot of reviews. I like a guy called Demon Seed. This is head up to you. I hope you're feeling better. I always watch your videos. I was waiting for you to get one of these to listen to the review, but I couldn't wait any longer. I think I'll call Pete for you and tell him to get you one. But anyways, I purchased one. I purchased some items to go with it. I'm hoping it's the right thing to do. It seemed the best out of all the reviews I've seen and whatever, and I'll explain why. But let me pull the box up. And I said in an earlier video that I really didn't open anything up. And I'm going to cut it open now. I haven't set it up or anything, but DJI sells the Mavic Pro, if you want to know. They sell it 2 different ways. You have the basic kit, and you have the Flymore combo kit. So I said to myself, I really don't need all that garbage that they give you. I've read bad reviews about the car charger, so why do I need that? I wanted a different style case, and that's what I was going to show you. I was waiting for this case. Out of all the cases I've seen, you kind of want portability. You don't want to... I have a nice case for the Phantom 4. It's huge. It can take impact. You can throw it around. But this one was more for portability. And the soft bag kind of... They say it scratches the Mavic, so just pretty basic. And I think... I haven't even tried it yet, but I think my tablet can go in here and the Mavic can go in here, and it's actually the whole Flymore combo with 3 batteries, drone, charger, so on and so forth will fit in this. Now, it's kind of a waterproof canvas, soft. I don't know how much of a beating it can take, but it's way better than the little sack that they give you for 90 bucks from DJI, I think. This is just all my assumptions on how I, Cruise Roy, wanted to set up his Mavic. So anyways, let me slide the box aside. So anyways, we're going to start with a few items. The first thing that I thought of, I have iPads for the Phantom 4, and really thin, really lightweight. You can use what you want. I've been using Apple products, but on the Mavic, it sounded like everybody's been having really good luck. And then plus, if you do videos, you get the NVIDIA Shield. So I got it with the charger and everything. You got to watch how you buy these. Sometimes they don't come with the charger. So I'll turn that on right now. But there it is, the NVIDIA Shield. Turn it on. All right, so between the iPad and the Shield, I'm going to try the NVIDIA Shield for the Mavic Pro. Now, next item I want to show you is they have different cords. In the box, they sent me a few items. This is a black and gold one for the Android. The Shield comes with one, so you could use either or. I got to get a shorter one. If I use the iPhone, look for one of these. It's the perfect size, but it depends on how you use it. If you put the Mavic in the controller, then this will work. If you use some kind of adapter, which some people do, the tablet adapters, the thing is, I wanted to see the little screen and I wanted to see the tablet. A lot of these adapters, it's right in front of the little screen. You can't see it. I don't understand it. They're promoting them, nice aluminum ones, blah, 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 blah. And it blocks the small controller screen. I like to see both. It's just me. I want to see both. I want to see if everything matches up from the DJI Go app to that screen. So I got the lanyard, cheap enough. And this is another adapter. This will go on the controller. So you can put the lanyard. All right? But I got a few options, so that's just one of the options. That's if I use the iPad tablet, which is the iPad Mini Air. Not Air, sorry. It's the iPad Mini 2. So from Dirty J Designs, this is what I got for an adapter. You get them off of Etsy. Just cut this open, and comes with instructions, pretty straightforward. All right, I print a lot of parts, I've designed a lot of parts, I've actually made a few things already for the Mavic, and it wasn't even out of the box. Dirty Designs makes this and he prints it, and it's a TSP, I think they call it. It's a flexible rubber. I've never seen it before. I know my printer cannot print it because otherwise I would have made something myself. But it comes carbon fiber rods and about 6 rubber parts. It's kind of a strong rubber, but this was my idea of a tablet holder. Of course, let's see if I can get it together here for you. All right, seems really strong, and it's just basically a rubber band that holds your tablet. You can't have it in any big cover though. It should have been wider. Plus, it's got the lanyard strap right here. And it locks into your Mavic controller. The problem with the Mavic controller is, I heard, if you start stuffing phones and iPad minis and all that into the controller, you start wrecking either the controller or your tablet. So this is a good idea, or whatever you pick. This, like I said, this is CruiseRoy's idea of what he wants in his Flymore package. Let me put that aside. Alright, so I got a few more connectors. I just got a, this one's another iPad connector, but braided line. I got them for the Phantom 4 as well. They work well. But, alright. Let's bring out the Mavic Pro. Hold on, let me get this plastic off. Now, I wanted something done a little bit different on mine than most. It's just customized the way I'd like it. And this is the first time I'm going to pull it out of this box. All right. What's weird is they put these little sticker guards on everything. And let me see how you open this. It's actually on one side. It tells you to open front, rear, front, rear. Got the props on the back. But in my mind, I thought this little guy looks like a 64 Mustang. Am I right or wrong? Looks like a 64 Mustang with a camera hanging off of it. And I wanted it detailed Cruise Royce limited edition. Nice gold metallic stripes. And I got my FAA on the back, if you can see it. And also Cruise Royce on the back. So that's what I had done to it. I guess it comes with all these little stickers, so I'll have to clean it up. Comes with a little juice in her. I don't have to tell you everything. You've been through a million reviews. Here's the controller. What I'm going to do is move the box out of the way. I'm going to take the props off real quick. She is pretty hefty, I'll tell you, for a little drone. Kind of like the Phantom 4 here. Kind of weird how they made it. Gave it two landing skids in the front, but the back ones are kind of tippy. But anyways, let me open the controller, discuss that. The thing was, everybody was talking about when you slide your tablets in here, it actually starts to wear out your tablet, but I can use, with these cables and this other cable, I can use my iPad Mini 2. And then I still got the stickers on there and everything. Try to get the antennas open. There we go. But let me try to put this together so you can look at it. With the dirty designs here. Bear with me. Just opened it up. You just tend to see so many videos that you kind of think you know what you're doing. Also, you got to watch these adapters. I've heard the switch, your sport mode switch. Depending on where this is, the wider you open it, you start hitting that switch. So there you are flying along. And you're in sport mode and you don't realize it because the button got hit by accident. But let me just see if this is in properly. Okay, looks it. Okay, that's all set. Doesn't feel too heavy. But put this on. I mean, the rubber band thing seems kind of flimsy, but I can still see the small screen. Let me put a cable to it. I think the only one I can use right now is this golden black one. I guess normally you use the side USB with your phone. But like, yeah, this is way too long. This was a bad choice. I'm gonna have to get a shorter one. of course, I'm used to the iPhone being able to be plugged in any direction. But on your NVIDIAs, it's only one direction, so let me see if I can tuck this garbage out of the way. Like I said, I'll have to find a shorter one. I kind of like the braided, but all right. So let's see what happens. I know it's not charged. Yeah, you gotta watch these buttons on the back of this guy. Okay, the Mavic pops up. Oh, hold on. I did a boo-boo. One thing you should never do, folks. You burn out your motors, and I just did it. Take off your cover, gimbal guard. Sorry about that. That was a stupid noob move. Now when you get this, it's probably going to say firmware, adjustment, you got to calibrate it outside. I'm inside right now, so won't be calibrating it. So you can take a look at it, NVIDIA Shield. What I like about it, it's got the screen recorder. And like I said, I can see the small controller and I can see the screen. And that's the exposure one. And this feels okay. It's not going to fall out of your hand. And what else? So the lanyard's a good fit. I didn't want to get something too big. All right, so I got the lanyard on. So, I'm liking it. Now I gotta get some warm weather. Yeah, this is kind of weird here. You're top heavy with the NVIDIA Shield, so it's gonna lay on the ground like that. Okay, so here's CruiseRoy's limited edition Mavic Pro. Asked them for the FAA number on the back and my name, and we just got to get ready to fly it. She is getting a little warm here. She does do that. I can hear the fan going, but we shut it off. Got to charge everything up. NVIDIA Shield. How do you shut it off? There we go. Boom. Alright, so real quick, I guess, let's bring over Big Bertha. And it's the Phantom 4 to the Mavic. It doesn't quite fit, so she's millimeters are a little smaller. Alright. Sorry, I'm just in awe. I'm just in awe. I'm very happy. Very, very happy. Got to start doing some flight tests, but very, very happy. So anyways, this is Cruise Roy with the Mavic Pro, the Phantom 1, Phantom 4, Old Faithful. And I hope you liked the video. And this is Cruise Roy, and I'm out of here.